In this video, we'll see how to perform arithmetic and logical operations of PIC microcontroller, PIC16F877 microcontroller. So here I have written one small program which just takes two numbers from memory locations 70 hex and 71 hex and performs different arithmetic and logical operations on those two numbers. So the address locations that I have taken is 70 hex and 71 hex. So one number will be stored at address location 70 hex and the second number will be stored at the address location 71 hex. So the first thing that is done here is move F70 hex comma 0. So with this, what will happen? The number stored at 70 hex location will be copied to working register. Next, add WF. So with this, the number stored at 71 address location will be added with the number present in working register, and the result will be again stored back in working register. After that, we have copied the result which is present in working register to the address location 72 hex. After that, again, same thing is done, just instead of addition, we have done subtraction. So first number is taken in working register, then second number is subtracted from the first number, and the result is stored in the 73 hex address location. After that, again, first number is taken, second number is added with the first number, result is stored at 74 hex address location. After that, again, first number is taken in working register. It is ORed with the second number present at 71 hex, and result is stored at 75 hex address location. Next, again, first number is taken in working register. It is XORed with the second number present at 71 hex address location, and result is stored at 76 hex address location. After that, we are going to send the result of XOR operation on port D. So before sending the result to port D, we have to configure port D as output port. And to do that, we have to put 00 in trist D register. So here 00 is taken in working register, and from working register it is sent to trist D. Instead of this, you can also use clearf trist D, which will do the same thing. After that, next, bank cell port D. So this bank cell is actually used for selecting the bank in which that particular register is present. And also, if suppose you are not going to use the address locations 70 hex to 7F hex, any other address locations, then we have to make sure that you have first of all selected the bank in which that address is present. After that, what we have done here is we have copied the result of XOR operation, which is stored at 76 hex address location, to working register, and from working register it is sent to port D. So this is the program that we have written. Now we can check the output. So before that, we have to build the program. So once it is built, we can now check the output. So these windows, this is a file register window, and this is a special function register window, which are available in the view menu of this software. Okay. So now we'll reset the program. We'll have the address location 70 hex. This is 70 hex. This is 71 hex address location. So I'll just change the numbers over here. Let's say 10. And I will put here, say, 20. So we have taken first number as 10, second number as 20. So after that, so now we'll use this single stepping option to execute one instruction at a time. So I'll just go to the main. So now the first instruction will be executed. So for that, again, using this instruction, the number present at 70 hex will be copied to working register. So here we have working register. Here you can check that the first number is now 10, which is available in this working register. Next, the numbers will be added and result is present in working register, and the same result is copied to the 72 address location, that is 30. So addition of 10 and 20 is 30. Next, similarly, same thing will happen, and again result is stored, result of subtraction is stored at 73 hex location, which is 10. After that, the result of ANDing will be stored as 00. Next, the result of ORing is 30 hex. Next, the result of XORing is also 30 hex. And now the next instruction is to make the port D as output port, which is available in TRIS D register. So we can go to TRIS D register over here. It is right now FF. So once this is executed, it will become 0, so which will make the port D as output port. And now we can check the result at the output of port D. The result of XOR should be available, that is 30 hex. So when I execute this, I will get here 30 hex. So in this way, we can perform different arithmetic and logical operations using PIC microcontroller. Thank you.